Wall Street is expecting that the newest update is going to drive the short-term sales trajectory, but what can we expect to drive the long-term sustainability of growth?
Innovation. GoPro has to keep innovating and coming out with new and exciting products that excite consumers. And I think we did that today with Hero 6 Black and Fusion. Hero 6 Black is far and away the most exciting and capable and easy to use GoPro that we've ever made. And then Fusion pushes GoPro into a totally new market with 360 spherical cameras. We think this is going to play an important role in the future of how people capture and share themselves, and Fusion is our first new product. And then we also made important advancements with Karma. It now has follow me functions and a cool new lookup feature that allows Karma to film what's above it, which is unique in drones. So I think that we're showing that GoPro is continuing to innovate and continuing to excite consumers.
So Karma and the spherical Fusion camera are new additions to the product line. How else are we going to see it evolve beyond the traditional action cameras?
Well, a big part of GoPro's future is we now see a GoPro as an untethered lens for your phone. What we mean by that is a GoPro now automatically copies any new photos and videos you capture over to your phone, and the GoPro app then creates a video for you. So when you use a GoPro, it's like using a separate untethered lens that offloads all its footage to your phone. So really, a GoPro is the ultimate capture complement to a phone, and that as we think of ourselves in that way and we think about new types of GoPros, new types of untethered lenses, we think we can dramatically expand our market.
Action cameras are maturing, smartphones are getting even better and more durable and waterproof. Mm-hmm. So what's your pitch to those consumers who say, I don't need another camera, my smartphone's good enough?
Well, I think that a phone is a phenomenal camera. It's often in your pocket and it's right there reactively when you want to film somebody or something else happening. But there's a lot of activities where you don't want to pull out your phone. You want to be more in the moment. And you also don't want to film somebody else. You want to film yourself. And so GoPro, with its untethered lens strategy, we think that we can make lenses that complement somebody's use of a phone, but not require them to pull the phone out or not even have the phone on them.
Now, the Hero 6 is using a custom design processor. This is the first time. So why decide to go this route, and what types of challenges are associated with making this yourself?
Oh, well, designing and developing a processor with a partner as we did, there's always risks involved, but there's also a risk that when you're reliant on others innovation and ingenuity that they put into their own work, into their own processors. And we found that what we wanted to do with Hero 6 Black, we couldn't do with any other processor that was on the market. So we had to develop our own. It allowed us to hit cost targets for the product. If we had even been able to do this with somebody else, Hero 6 Black would have had to be more expensive to the end consumer, so that's not good. So we were able to deliver Hero 6 at a lower price point, and we were able to hit performance levels that would have otherwise been impossible.
So last year was a challenge.
We're taking our destiny into our own hands from a technology standpoint.
And on that point, last year was pretty challenging from a technical standpoint. There were some product delays. So what have you learned from those experiences to make sure that the rollout of this year's products are seamless?
We're doing fewer things better. In previous years, we had other businesses we were running, like our media business. We had many programs going on in products that consumers never saw that were more targeted towards professionals. We cut all of that and focused GoPro on what it does best and what our whole vision and mission is to help people capture and share their lives so that they can celebrate the moment in a way that they just can't with any other camera.
Being a hardware company is very difficult in the public markets. GoPro shares have fallen quite dramatically since the IPO. So what are investors missing?
I think investors are missing that we're growing again. The previous comp of 2016, people think that unit sales are way down, volumes were higher in previous years, but what they need to look at is that volumes of our premium products, $299 and above, are growing. We're selling more of the products that matter and of the products that have better margin for GoPro and make us more profit. So GoPro is healthy and it's growing, and I think investors are starting to take notice.
And let's quickly talk about drones. Many analysts say that the market leader DJI has superior features and a similar price point. So given those market effects, how much of a revenue driver do you see drones becoming for GoPro?
We're really excited about drones. Karma is doing well. It's a phenomenal accessory for the GoPro community. It's very versatile with the detachable gimbal and how it connects to the Karma grip. And our customers have spoken. They really like that flexibility, that versatility, and Karma continues to get better. You know, today we announced Follow Me features, as well as a lookup feature that allows Karma to film what's above it, which, as I mentioned, is unique to drones. And we're going to continue to innovate and advance our drone offering into what comes after Karma.